So you get introduced to your neighbors as someone who is a letter bomb suspect, which is never great for relations exactly. around the community. And then you wind up being taken into custody. And how intense did it get in there with investigators? What were the stakes? What were they doing to you and saying to you?
Well, they were nice. The Homeland Security officer, the Capitol Police lady from Washington, and a gentleman from the FBI. Do I mention any names? I think it was Officer Grant, Agent Grant. Very respectful. There was only one individual in that room that was agitated with me, and he was shaking and very nervous. I think he knew that, you know, we don't have enough on this guy, guys. I don't want to compromise my job. I've got a job to do. But I think he had been in it long enough over the years that he felt some form of uncertainty, because I'm an impersonator. I've impersonated thousands of different cartoon characters and people. And so I'm studying his human behavior, and I'm just picking up on the shakiness and the nervousness and the friction in his voice and how he can't look me in the eye. And he wanted me to sign papers to release all medical records from my whole life and mental records to him. And I said, sir, my ex-wife is in criminal justice. She wants to be a lawyer. And we were just talking the other night over dinner, and she told me, don't ever sign anything if you're ever in a situation, but unless your lawyer's there. And I said, sir, can I have an attorney here present? And they go, absolutely not. Well, then I'm not signing it. He grabbed those papers and jerked them back and said, well, that's just fine. And then it became a good guy, bad guy. Officer Grant, he was a good guy. His guy is a bad guy. And then the lady in the back, wonderful. She was so polite from Washington. And they treated me like gold, but they intensely interrogated me for hours. And it was nerve-wracking. I can't even express. My inside nerves were like going to come out of my ears.